Okay, so let's go straight to chapter 3. Para tapos na tayo dito sa chapter 3. Bago tayo mag, ano, para ma, bigyan ko kayo ng mahabang breathing time. Kasi malapit na ang ating midterm, October. Midterms natin ng October. So meron pa tayong 2 weeks. And kailangan next week tapos na natin tong chapter 3. Okay, so anyone please read the learning objectives for the chapter 3? Yes, Noelin.
Learning objectives: compare and contrast inductive and deductive reasoning. Use different types of reasoning to justify statements and arguments made about mathematics and mathematical concepts. Apply the Polya's 4-step in problem solving. Organize one's method and procedures for proving and solving problems. Perform operations on mathematical expressions correctly.
Anja? Plus 4, bakit sir? Puno na ako, sir. Okay, thank you, Noelin. So, next, please continue. Okay, Justin, please continue. Oh, napindot na naman nata ni Justin. Sinong pwede magbasa? Okay, MC.
Learning objectives. First, articulate the importance of mathematics in one's life. Second, express appreciation for mathematics as a human endeavor. Third, support the use of mathematics in various aspects and endeavors in life. Fourth, affirm honesty and integrity and the application of mathematics to various human endeavors.
Okay, thank you. So next, the topic outline. So we have inductive and deductive reasoning. We have intuition, proof, and certainty. The Polya's 4-step in problem solving. We have the problem solving strategies, mathematical problems involving patterns, and recreational problems using mathematics. So we go to inductive reasoning. So please read. Okay, Marian.
Inductive reasoning is drawing a general conclusion from a repeated observation or limited sets of observations of specific examples. Given data, then we draw a conclusion based from the same this data from specific case to general case. Conjecture is drawing conclusion using inductive reasoning. The conjecture may be true or false depending on the truthfulness of the argument.
Okay, thank you. So, this is a letter from Goldbach to Euler. We dated 1742. Makikita nyo dyan, this is a mathematics paper. So, ang kwento nito is may tinatanong si Goldbach kay Euler and proving ng mga expressions. Or the statement, dito nang galing yung statement na every even integer greater than 2 can be expressed as the sum of 2 primes. So remember these two mathematicians. So siguro familiar din sa inyo si Euler. Hindi ruler ha, Euler. Yun, Fermat's last theorem. So Pierre de Fermat. So, Fermat's last theorem or Fermat's conjecture, no 3 positive integers, a, b, and c, satisfy the equation a raised to n plus b raised to n is equals to c is raised to n for any integer value of n greater than 2. So, ibig sabihin yan, A raised to 3 plus B raised to 3, C raised to 3. So, walang positive integers na magsasatisfy na yan ay tama. Kapag mas mataas sa 2 ang formula. Kaya wala kayong makikita ang A raised to 3, A cube plus B cube is equals to C cube. Pero magkakita kayo ng C squared plus B squared is equals to C squared. Diba? Tama ba? May formula bang ganon? A squared plus B squared is equals to C squared? Oh, hindi natanda. O saan formula yon?
Pythagorean theorem.
Okay. So, yun. Formula yon sa Pythagorean theorem. So next we have Wiles. So Wiles, Sir Andrew John Wiles, proved that Fermat's last theorem on September 19, 1994, and was published in May 1995 in a dedicated volume of the Annals of Mathematics. So ang ginawa ni Sir Andrew John Wiles dito is nagkaroon siya ng mga computations para ma-prove na ang formula na ito ay hanggang squared lang. Hindi na siya lalampas doon and wala nang ibang makakapag-satisfy sa conditions na A squared plus B squared is C squared, or pagka tinaas niya yan, wala nang, hindi na siya mag-equal. Yan lang yan. So, inductive reasoning. Inductive reasoning, please read counterexample. Anyone? Yung iba naman na di pa dyan nakakapagsalita. Okay, Von.
Counterexample. If a statement is a true statement provided that it is true in all cases and it only takes one example to prove the conjecture is false.
Okay, so counterexample, we have one example, 1 is an odd number, 11 is an odd number, 21 is an odd number, thus all number ending 1 are odd numbers. So, ayan. So, example number 2. Essay test is difficult. Problem solving test is difficult. Therefore, all tests are difficult. So, ano yung nakikita nyong mali dito? Kasi meron namang mga test na madali. Tama ba? Hello?
Opo.
Oh, kasi balikan natin yung counterexample. Counterexample, if a statement is a true statement, provided that it is a true in all cases and it only takes one example to prove the conjecture is false. So, sa example number 2, paano natin siya mapuprove na hindi? Kasi merong test na madali. So, example number 3, Mark is a science teacher. Mark is bald. Therefore, all science teachers are bald. Okay. So, anong statement ang sasabihin nyo dito para ma-disprove nyo na hindi tama na lahat ng science teacher ay kalbo?
Kasi po may mga babae pong science teacher.
Okay, pwede rin yun. Pwede na sabihin na may mga babaeng science teacher na may buhok and hindi naman sila kalbo. So, yun, pwede yun. So, deductive reasoning. Okay, so please read deductive reasoning. Yes, Lee.
Deductive reasoning is a drawing general to specific examples or simply from general case to specific case. Deductive starts with a general statement or hypothesis and examines to reach a specific conclusion.
Okay, specific conclusion. So example, all birds have feathers. Ducks are birds, therefore ducks have feathers. Number 5, Christopher is sick. If Christopher is sick, he won't be able to go to work. Hello, hello.
Ako kayo.
Mic test. Mawawala ako. Hello.
Okay na ba, sir? Yes, panalimit.
Okay na.
Narinig na po.
Naputol ba ako dito sa duck? Hindi naman.
Opo. Naputol po kayo, sir, dun.
Okay, so, statement 1, all birds have feathers. Ducks are birds. Therefore, ducks have feathers. So, example. So, madideduce natin na ang ducks ay bird. So, since ang birds ay may feathers, therefore, ducks have feathers. So Christopher is sick. So if Christopher is sick, he won't be able to go to work. Therefore, Christopher won't be able to go to work. So example 6, all science teachers are bald. Mark is a science teacher. Therefore, Mark is bald. So ayan. Yung unang dalawang statement, naka-rely doon ang ating conclusion. So, parang review na din ito ng inyong research. Yan. So, this is a logical reasoning. So, note, logical reasoning may be valid but not necessarily true. Okay? So, inductive versus deductive reasoning. So, kapag nag-conduct kayo ng deductive reasoning, you have the general principle, then you will go specifically into a special case, katulad ng ating duck. Ang duck natin, ano ba general principle? All birds have feathers. That is very general. Then, a duck is a bird. So, it is also general. Then specifically, specific to ducks, ducks have feathers. So that is a special case. So when we do inductive reasoning, so we take special cases or special cases, yung mga specific na object or yung mga nakikita natin, then we arrive in a conclusion generally, katulad nung kalbo kanina. Sinabi natin na ang teacher ko ay kalbo. Ang si Sir Mark ay kalbo. Ay, hindi pala. Si Sir Mark ay kalbo. Si Sir Mark ay science teacher. Therefore, lahat ng science teacher ay kalbo. So, ganun yung general principle. So, inductive reasoning. So, intuition, proofs, and certainty. So, intuition. Aglit lang. So, intuitive can be found in mathematical literature and discovery. So we have these two people, Srinivasa Ramanujan and G.H. Hardy. So the Ramanujan wrote Letter to Godfrey, Harold Hardy, on infinite sums, products, fractions, and roots. So his formula proves that there is mathematical intuition, though he didn't prove them. So Hardy made a sound judgment without directly proving the formulas. So what is the mathematical intuition? Please read. Okay, Angelo.
Mathematical intuition. Intuition is a reliable mathematical belief without being formalized and proven directly and serves as an essential part of mathematics.
Okay. So, intuition carries a heavy load of mystery and ambiguity, and it is not a legitimate substitute for a formal proof. So, ano ba yung mathematical intuition? Halimbawa, nasa isip nyo, 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. So, yan, mathematical intuition yan. Alam nyo, sa isip nyo, 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. Pero, paano nyo siya ipoprove? So, kailangan may physical proof na kaya, of formal proof. So, intuitive is being visual and is absent from the rigorous, formal, or abstract version. Proofs. Ayan, hinahanap na yung proofs. Paano nyo ipoproof na 1 plus 1 is equals to 2? So, proof is an inferential argument for the mathematical statement. So, mathematical argument like theorems can only be used if it is already proven. Okay, axioms may be served as conditions that must be met before the statement applies. Proofs are examples of exhaustive deductive reasoning and inductive reasoning. So, yung mga naitan yung theory of relativity ni Einstein. So, meron yung kaiakibat na mga reasoning and computations para ma-prove yan, but it stays as theory kasi nga theory pa siya, hindi pa siya, iba pa kasi ang theory sa fact. Okay, so kung may nakita kayo na mga Pythagorean theorem, theory siya, hindi siya fact, pero ginagamit natin siya as reference para mapadali yung ating mga ginagawa kasi meron siyang evidences na nagbaback up na the theories exist. So, ganun ang mga proofs. So, once na ma-prove nyo and they have a solid evidence and everybody agrees to the that the theory is correct, it will then come into a fact or what we call the law. Ano ba yung law? Law of motion, law of gravitation, law of buoyancy. Yon. So, law of conservation of mass and momentum. Yung mga ganong law. So, yung mga yun nagsimula sa theory, na-prove, na tama. So, naging fact na siya and naging loss na siya. So, ayun yung history nun. So, proofs, a mathematical proof demonstrates that a certain statement is always true and in all possible cases, an unproved proposition that is believed to be true is known as a conjecture. Okay, so, kung hindi kayo hindi siya naging theory, magiging conjecture siya. Kasi may kailangan pa kayong i-prove para para talaga maging theory siya. So, if one has a conjecture, the only way that it can safely be sure that it is true is by presenting a valid mathematical proof. So, certainty. Certainty, mathematics has a tradition and standard point of view that it provides certainty. So, yun na ngayon, katulad nung 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. So, certain na tayo na 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. Kasi may dalawa kong object dyan. Number 1, number 2. Pag plusin mo yung dalawang object, magiging 2. So, a correct formulated mathematical knowledge is forever beyond error and correction. Meaning, if it is already proven na correct and wala nang ibang way para ma-prove siya na wrong, so it is forever na hindi na siya magkakamali. Na yun ang naging formula and naging solution para sa isang bagay na iyon. Katulad ng 1 plus 1 equals to 2. So, mathematical certainty is an essential defining attribute of mathematics and mathematical knowledge. So, Polyas, 4 steps in problem solving. So, sino ba si Polya? So, George Polya was a mathematics educator who strongly believed that the skill of problem solving can be taught. So, niwala siya na kaya nating matutunan tong mga problem solving skills. So, na-develop siya ng isang framework known as Polya's 4 Step in Problem Solving. So, the process address the difficulty of students in problem solving. So, please read steps 1 to 4. Okay, nawiling.
Polya's 4 steps in problem solving. Step 1, understand the problem. Step 2, devise a plan. Step 3, carry out the plan. Step 4, look back.
Okay. So, problem solving, number 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, kapag nag-reflection kayo, then pag may nakita pa ulit kayong problem, babalik kayo sa step 1. So, paikot siya. So, process of problem solving. Anong una? Anong nasa screen? Mark Jerry Mendoza? Anong unang process ng problem solving?
Original problem ko, sir.
Okay, original problem. So, Pia Marie Paniza, ano ang kasunod? Diyan ka ba, Pia? Okay, RB, ikaw na lang. Ano yung sunod?
Mathematical version of the problem.
Okay. So, next. Sino hindi pa natatawag dyan kanina? Oh, Michael.
Answer to original problem.
Okay, answer to the original problem. So, next. Okay, Felix.
Solution to the mathematical version.
Okay. So, ito ang ating problem solving. So, we have the original problem. So, you translate the problem into a mathematical version of the problem. Then you solve the mathematical version of the problem, then you would get the answer, then you interpret it to the solution, then you would check with the original problem kung tama ba yung nakuha mo, or nasagot ba nung nakuha mo yung itinatanong mo sa original problem. Okay, so step 1. We have the understanding the problem. Tatanong niya, what is the goal? What is being asked? What is the condition? What sort problem of is it? What is known or unknown? Is there enough information? Can you draw a figure to illustrate the problem? Is there a way to restate the problem in your own words? Okay, so step 2, devise a plan. Gawin mo, act it out. Be systematic. Work backwards. Consider special cases. Eliminate possibilities. Perform an experiment. Draw a picture or diagram. Make a list or table chart. Use a variable such as x. Okay, so you can also look for formula or formulas kapag ka nag-exist siya. Pwede kang gumawa ng sarili mong equation. Or pwede kang gumawa ng model. You can look for certain patterns. You can direct or indirect reasoning. You can solve a simple version of the problem. So, masyadong broad yung inyong subject, pwede nyong i-simplify yon. Then, guess and check your answer by trial and error. And then, we can go and carry out the plan. So, be patient. While working, work carefully. Modify the plan or try a new plan. Yes, Angelo?
Sir, nawala po.
Saan na o nawala?
Then po sa step 2 po na part.
Dito?
Yes po, nag-ana po bigla yung...
Ano, nawala talaga kanina? Maulan pa ba? Maulan pa eh. Okay, so yan na lang. Pakibasa na lang. Look for patterns. Use direct or indirect reasoning. Solve a simple version of the problem. Guess and check your answer. So, carry out the plan. Yan. Then, step 4. Look back. See your solution. Does the answer make sense? Check the results in the original problem. And, yan. So, problem solving strategies. Okay, pakibasa. Yes, Jenny?
Example number 1. Sa PA basketball championship, decided the best of 5 series different way can at win the championship.
Okay. So ngayon, yan yung main question. So ngayon, understand the problem. So step 1. So ano yung problem? Many different orders to win the championships. So, the team may have won win-win-win or lose-lose, win-win-win. So, now devise a plan. So, make an organized list of all possible orders and ensure that each of the different orders is accounted for only once. So, isang beses lang yung sagot na yan. The next we have the step 3, carry out the plan. Each entry in the list must contain 3 W's and may contain 1 or 2 losses. So, ilan sila? So, we can start with 3 wins, then dagdagan nyo ng isang win, 2 wins, then lipat nyo yung lose, lipat nyo yung dalawang lose, gitnaan nyo, lagay nyo sa una, yan, and hanggang sa maubos nyo ang conditions. May kulang pa dito. Pwede rin dito yung loose nandun sa dulo na isa. Then may loose na nandun sa pinakadulo na dalawa. Ah, hindi na pala pwede yun kasi nanalo na. Ang 3 wins nga pala sa harap. So, ayan lang pala yung pwede. Ilan lang yan? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, 10 possibilities. So, look back, check if the list contains no duplications, included all possibilities. Conclude that there are 10 different ways to win the NCAA championships in the best of 5 games. Yan. So, nandito pala ang perpetual. So, NCAA. So, example 2. We have 2 times the sum of a number and 3 is equals to thrice the number plus 4. Find the number. Okay, so understand the problem. Read the question carefully several times. Look for a number and let x be a number. So devise a plan. Translate 2 times the sum of a number and 3 is equal to thrice the number. So ano siya? 2 times the sum of a number and 3 is equals to thrice the number plus 4. So, step 3, we carry out the plan. Carry out the plan. Solve for the value of x. So, distribute number 2. 2x plus 6 equals 3x plus 4. 3x. Lipat mo yung 2x, lipat mo yung negative, yung 4 para maging negative 4, 3x minus 2x equals 6 minus 4, x is equals to 2. So, look back, pwede nyong gamitin yung x, dahil yung x is equals to 2, pwede nyong gamitin to solve kung magtutugma ba yung parehas ng equation. So, pwede nyong i-substitute tong si number 2. Oh, wait lang. Pwede nyong i-substitute itong si number 2 dito sa inyong x. Ito, tsaka dito para makita nyo ang value ng kung tama yung inyong nakuha. So, next, step 3. We have 3 siblings. Sophia, Akaya, and Rihanna. Sophia gave Akaya and Rihanna as much money as each had. Then Akaya gave Sophia and Rihanna as much money as each had. Then Rihanna gave Sophia and Akaya as much money as each had. Then each of the 3 had 128 pesos. How much money did each have originally? So, to understand the problem is confusing but must be carefully analyzed. So, devise a plan. We would be working backwards. So, to carry out the plan, problem has 4 stages. So, kung magagaling tayo sa dulo, each has 128 pesos. So, Rihanna gave Sophia and Akaya. So, Akaya gave Sophia and Rihanna. Then, Sophia gave Akaya and Rihanna. Yan. So, ginamitan siya ng table. So, 128. And kung makikita nyo dyan, nag-distribute yan. And magka-come up tayo sa solution na Sophia initially had 208 pesos, Akaya had 112 pesos, and Rihanna had 64 pesos. So, check the result. Yan. The Sophia, Akaya, and Rihanna's initial money are 208, 112 pesos, and 64 pesos respectively. So, example number 4. If the length of the top of a rectangle is 15 inches more than its width and the area is 1,350 square inches, find the dimension of the table. Okay. So, sinong pwedeng mag-solve nito? O, solve niya pala. If the length of the top of a rectangle is 15 inches more than its width and the area is 1,350 square inches, find the dimension of the table. Okay, so nandito ang area 1,350 square meters, square inches. Square inches and length of the top of rectangle is 15 inches more than its width. Ang length is equals to width plus 15 inches. Okay, sino pwedeng mag-solve? O makaka-solve? Okay, pakisolve muna. Babalikan ko ng 3 p.m. Okay, meron ba nakasolve? Hello, meron ba nakasolve ng example number 4? Okay, Felix. Anong dimension ng ating table?
Sir, ang length po ay 45 po, tapos ang width po ay 30.
Okay, so may iba pa dyan na nagsagot? Na nagsolve? Si Felix lang ba? Wala na. Ah, sige, Felix, may PPM ako sa'yo mamaya. Okay, so, ano ulit ang length mo? Na nakuha?
Ang length po ay 45 po.
At ang?
Tapos ang width po ay 30.
Okay, tingnan natin kung tama yung
30 inches mo.
So, length and width. So, look for the length and width of the table. So, length, 15 plus width. So, tama ito. Divide sa plan. So, area is equals to length times width. So, 1,350 is equals to length times width. And substituting length. So, since ang length natin is equals to 15 plus width, substitute natin ng 15 plus width times width. Then, solve na natin. So, ang width natin is minus 45. Yan. Sorry. So, the width of the rectangle is 30 and length ng ating lamesa is 45 inches. So, tama si Felix. Okay. So, look back. Yan. Then, multiply mo yung 45 and 30 and you would come up with 1,350 square inches. Okay, so, mathematics is useful to predict. Number pattern leads directly to the concept of functions in mathematics. And number pattern is applied to the problem, solving whether a problem is present and used to generalize a solution to a problem. Okay. So, pattern can be in form, counting up or down, and the missing number is of the form of completing count up or down. So, previously, yan, nandiyan yung mga patterns natin. Ano ba ang famous number patterns? Fibonacci, number patterns, the prime number pattern, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, imaginary number pattern. The I raised to 1, or square root of negative 1, I raised to 2, negative 1, I raised to 3, or the negative I raised to 4, which is 1, I raised to 5, square root of negative 1, or the geometric number pattern, so isang triangle, dalawang triangle, tatlong triangle, or the growing number pattern, so 9, then magiging 18, 27, sequence, so we have infinite sequences, a function of whose domain is the set of positive integers. So, terms of the sequence are a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, a sub 4, a sub a so on, a n negative 1, a n so on and so forth. So, finite sequence, if the domain of the function consists of the first n positive integers, only the sequence is a. So, for example, ito may skier tayo. Ang sequence niya is nagsimula sa jump, then mag-e-ending sa landing. So, finite in infinite sequence, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. So, these are finite sequences. Meanwhile, pag nagdagdag kayo na so on and so forth, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, so on and so forth. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, so on and so forth. And 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, so on and so forth. These are infinite sequences. So general sequence. So having the first term A1, the second term is A2, the third term is A3, and the nth term, also called the general term of the sequence, is A sub to the number. Example 2. Write the first terms of the sequence whose nth term is given by the formula A sub n is equals to 3n plus 1. Solution, A sub n is equals to 3n plus 1. A sub 1, yan. So, A, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, replace n by 1, replace n by 2, replace n by 3. So, makikita natin yung pattern is 4, 7, 10. Then, pagka tinuloy pa natin yan ng 4, so on and so forth, yung sum na makukuha niya is susunod sa 4, 7, 10, the next number, the next number, the next number, the next number. Okay, thus the first three terms of the sequence are 4, 7, and 10. So, difference table shows the differences between successive terms of the sequence. Difference in rows may be the first, second, and third differences. Each number in the first row of the table is the differences between the closest numbers or just above it. So, if the first difference are not the same, compute the successive differences of the first differences. So, example 3, construct the difference table to predict the next term of each sequence. So, 3, 7, 11, 15, 19, 1, 4, 9, 17, 28, 6, 9, 14, 25, 15, 91, so on and so forth. So, solution for number letter A. So, yung sequence, first differences niya ay 4. So, meaning, ang susunod kay 19 ay may difference dapat na 4, which is 23. So, meaning, 19 plus 4 is equals to 23. And sumunod pa sa kanya is 27. Yan. So next, solution to B, 1, 4, 9, 17, 28. So ano ang kanyang difference? Anyone? Sino makakapagsabi ng differences niya?
So, 5, 8, 10.
Okay, pa ulit. Ano yung una?
Doon po sa 1 and 4 po ay, 3.
Teka lang. Asan yung ano ko? Wala yung lapis ko. Okay, so, anyway, ano yung una? 1 and 4? 3? Tapos yung sunod?
3 po. Tapos, 5 po.
5? Sunod?
8? 8 po. Tsaka 8. Po, 11.
Then, 11. Okay. 3, 5, 8, 11. So next, ano yung second differences niya? Anyone? Okay, MC, tuloy mo. Ano yung sunod?
2 po.
A2?
2.
3 and
3 po.
3. Kaya natin kung tama. O bakit 3 yung isa? ML. error dito. 3. Ah, kasi 3 siya dito. No, ano? Dapat 2. Sana yan, nakita natin may error dito. Next term is 42. So, solution ng C. Hey. Next, sinong pwede? Okay, sagot. Difference table. Habang hinahanap ko lang yung lapis. Okay, anyone? Sinong pwede? Okay, Charles.
Sir, 3.
Ano yung una?
3 po.
3?
Okay, 3? 5 po.
5?
12 po.
12?
24
po. 24. And 41. 41. Okay. Tingnan natin. 3, 5, 12, 24, 41. So, second differences. Okay, Nadine.
Ano po? 2, 7, 12,
17. 17. So, tingnan natin to kung baka kasi 3 na naman to. O yan. Tama yung sagot ni ano nga pangalan nun?
Mawilin po.
So, ayan, 2. Ito yung sagot ni Nawilin, so, which is tama. And, sagot din kanina ni, sino ba yung nagsagot kanina? MC. Si MC. Yun. So, kanina, nag-error lang. Dapat is 2 yung kanina. So, second differences, may third differences pa. So, sino ang pwedeng magsagot nun? Kay Marian.
Five.
Greenwich Delivery. Okay, so third differences is 5. And since ang next na difference natin is 5, so plus 17 plus 5, 22. And 41 plus 22 is 63. And 91 plus 63 is equals to 154. So yan ang sunod sa ating solution. Then, pagka mag-a-add pa tayo, lalagay pa tayo ng 5 dito. Ayan yung plus 27. Then, plus pa ulit. And so on and so forth. Okay, so next mathematical problem involving patterns. So, the first chapter was about patterns. So, determine the nth number formula for the following polygonal numbers in the nth figure. So, A, we have a triangular number. B, we have a square number. C, pentagonal number. And D, the hexagonal number. So, solution for the patterns or the polygonal numbers is a type of figurative number represented as dots or pebbles arranged in shape of a regular polygon. So, triangular number, yan, 1, then 3, 6, 10, 15. So the number sequence is 1, then n is 2, and 1 plus 2 magiging 3, 1 plus 2 plus 3 magiging 6. So dinadagdagan mo yung base niya. Kung makikita niya dito, ito 1, then 1, 2, 3. 3. Then ito yung naunang 3. Then dinagdagan niyo ng 3. Then nagdagan ng 4. Nagdagan ng 5. So pag nagulit pa tayo dito, nadagdagan ng 6. Naging 21. Okay. So ayan, 21. So the expansion sa triangular geometric pattern natin is 1, 3, 6, 10, 15, 21, 28, 36, 45, 55, so on and so forth. So it is an infinite pattern or sequence. So generalized as T sub n is equals to 1 plus 2 plus 3 and n minus 1 n is equals to 1 half parenthesis n squared plus n. So, square number. Pag square number naman, and ito, then 9, kasi nagdagdag tayo ng 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so, ayan. Then, 25, oh, sa number sequence niya is 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared, 4 squared, 5 squared, 6 squared. So, ito yung ilalagay niyo na additional dito sa labas. So, number 9, ito, 3 squared. Ah, so, generalized as the formula S sub n is equals to 1 half parenthesis 2 n squared minus 0n is equals to n squared. So, n squared po ay ito. Yan. Itong number na ito. Yan mga yan. Okay, so we have pentagonal number. So, pentagonal, the sequence is this one. So, we have 1 point. So, we have plus 4 para maging 5. Then, 1 plus 4 plus 7. 12 plus 10 plus 13 plus 16. So, ang formula niya ay ito. Yan. Paano niyo makukuha? Ilagay niyo yung n dito. N na ito ay itong column na ito. Kasama itong n na ito. Para makuha nyo yung idadagdag nyo na number. Okay, so expansion. And we have hexagonal. So the same. Self-explanatory na yung n. Lipat nyo na lang dito. Then we'll get the expansion of 1, 6, 15, 28, 45, 66, 91. So on and so forth. So, a diagonal of a polygon is a line segment that connects vertices of the polygon. Following are polygons, triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, and hexagon. Determine the number of diagonals in a pentagon and an octagon. So, remember this question kasi ay may lumabas na ganito sa board exam. Diagonals. So, solution, sequence of the diagonals. So, determine number of sides. So, number of sides is 3. 3 na ito. Then, dapat ang kanyang diagonals is 0. Then, 4. Kasi ang diagonals niya ay 2. So, 4. Na tayo niyan. So, sa 5 sides, sa pentagon, up. Hindi pantay. Tayong 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yan. So, hexagon, we have 9 diagonals. 7, 8. So, paano nyo? Pero may formula kasi ito. Pwede nyo gamitin yung... No, ito nyo. Pentagon, octagon. And example number 6 na pala tayo. So, pwede nyo kunin yung difference table. Gamitin nyo itong 2, 5, 9 para makuha nyo yung tawag dito. Kasi may pattern tong diagonals na to with respect sa sides ng ating polygons. So, yun yung itinuturo dito na formula ng pagkuha ng diagonals. So, pentagon, 14 diagonals. Octagon has 20 diagonals. Yan siya pag i-drawing. So, next we have example number 6. Given a circle with endpoints on its perimeter, what is the maximum number of regions determined by the chords and the circle rim? So, solution, n is equals to 0 and continuing the case to n equals to 6. So, meron tayong n1, n2, n3, n4, n5, n6. So, locate a point on a circle and connect it with the other point on a circle and count the number of regions it generates. So, number of chords and regions produced with given n points in a circle. So, yan. So, every time na nahahati, ang dami, padami ng padami. So, 1, 2, 3. So, kung ilang number of chords. Ano ba ang chord? Ang chord ito. So, ilan ba ang points na nirecommend sa atin is 6. So, kada point niya na nadagdagan, bawa 1, nag-point ka dito, nag-point ka dito, nag-point ka dito, maging triangle. So, ito yung original mo triangle. Nag-point ka dito. So, lahat ng point na ito, mapupunta dito. Magkoconnect yan. Okay? So, as you add more points, bawa ito point number 5, nadagdagan na ulit. So, yung mga points na to, nag-connect ulit papunta dun sa tinagdag natin na point. Then, the same with point number 6. So, the question is ilang regions? So, regions natin is 31. So, 7 points. Pwede rin natin gamitin itong formula na ito. Pascal's triangle. So, one of the ancient square mathematical recreations of all is the magic square. So, this is in China, a Chinese myth on time of Emperor Yu. Come across as a sacred turtle with a strange marking on its shell, known as Lo Shu. So, yan. The markings are numbers and they form a square pattern of order 3. In 1514, the artist Albert Durer made an engraving, Melancholia, containing a square pattern of order 4. So, asan yung order 4? Ito, order 4. Bakit siya order 4? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yan. And magic square. Magic square of order n is an arrangement of numbers in a square such that the sum of the n numbers in each row, column, and diagonal is the same number. Yan. Nakita nyo ba to? Lahat na pag pinag-add nyo to, pababa. Pinag-add nyo to, pababa. Add nyo, pababa. 15 yan. Add nyo pa kanan, add nyo pa kanan, add nyo pa kanan. 15. O kahit diagonals niya is 15. Okay, so that is the magic square of order 3. So, order 4, the same. palindrome. So a palindrome is a number or word or phrase, a sequence of characters or symbols which reads the same backward as forward. So for example, 131, 12321, 1234321. Yan. Ano pa ang example? 121. 12321, 12342, 12343321, 14345431. Yan. So 9-digit palindrome primes, palindromic primes. Meaning hindi sila na-divide ng kahit anong number, it is only divisible by itself and 1. So 1888881. Tingnan niyo na lang. Hirap basahin. So Pascal's triangle, one of the most famous palindrome triangles is the Pascal's triangle, named after the French mathematician Blaise Pascal. Okay, so familiar siguro sa inyo itong si Blaise Pascal kasi siya rin yung malapit na sa mga computers. Kasi siya yung gumawa na Pascaline. Kung naalala nyo history sa computers, siya yon. So, Pascal's triangle has intrigued mathematicians for hundreds of years. So, since the triangle was first published by Zhu Xije or on 1260-1320, a Chinese mathematician in 1306 in his Xiwan Yuxian, it was called Jiaxian triangle or Yanghui triangle by the Chinese. So, Blaise Pascal's version ng triangle is ito. Yan. Then, yung Chinese version is the same dito. Nag-iba lang siya ng arrangement. So, pagko-compare natin sila is they have the same principle na pag nag-multiply 1, 1, so, 1 plus 1, 2. So, 3. Yan, 1 plus 2, 3. Then, magkatabi 3. Then, 1, 3, and 1, ay 5. 1, 4, 3. So, pag pinag-plus mo is 8. So, on and so forth. So, simple number triangles. So, lazy Cater's problem. Lazy Cater's sequence describes the maximum number of pieces of a pizza that can be made with a given number of straight cuts. So, one straight cut across a pizza produces 2 pieces. So, tunay naman yun kasi pag hinati natin dito sa gitna, hindi diretso. So, dalawang piraso na siya, left and right. So, 2 straight cuts. Assume natin, straight yung pagkakaputol ko. O, may 4 pieces na siya. Pag nag 3 straight cuts na tayo, is we have maximum of 7 pieces. Pero ilan ta? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Diba? Bakit ganun? So, 4 straight cuts produces a maximum of 11 pieces. Pero pag hinati natin dito is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hindi siya 11. Determine the number of pieces in which it is the maximum possible pieces to divide the pizza for a given number of straight cuts. So, illustrating the number of cuts and the number of regions it creates. So, ayan. Nagkaroon tayo ng cut. Number 1. May region tayo ganyan, cut number 2. So, dyan, ganyan siya kinat nung number 4. 3 and 4. Yan, 3. Kaya siya naging 7. And 4, naging 11. So, to maximize the number of pieces in the next cut, the nth cut, must cut each of the n minus 1 previous one. So the new cut meets one of the n minus 1 previous one. A pizza piece is cut into two. A piece cut into, when the new cut finishes on the opposite side of the pizza, total number of pizza increases by n. When we pass from n minus 1 cuts to n cut, which is exactly why the recurrence reveals. The recurrence relation with the nth cut creates new regions. So f of 1 is equals to 2, f of 2 is equals to 4 equals 2 plus f of 1, f of 3 is equals to 3, 7 equals 3 plus f of 2, f of 4 is equals to 11 is equals to 4 plus f of 3. And the formula is f of n is equals to n plus f of n minus 1. Therefore, f of n is equals to n plus f of n minus 1. Yan. So, evaluating n, for n, substitute nyo lang yung n dito. So, ang makukuha nyo values is 1, 2, 4, 7, 11, 16, 22, 29. So, fake coin problem. Fake coin problem, there are 12 coins identical in appearance and a balance beam. If exactly one of these coins is fake and heavier than the other 11, find the fake coin using the most using at most 3 weights on a balance beam. So, solution, the balance beam has no graduation for weights. They just have 2 pans. So, wala siyang measurement. Wala tayong way para malaman kung tama ba yung bigat niya or kung gano'n siya kabigat. So, may magle-label ka ng coins ng 1 to 12. So, three possible outcomes. The two sides of the beam are balanced, indicating that the coin is in the two pans are not fake. So, meaning, pag dinivide mo sa 2 yung coins mo and nag-balance siya, parehas ang weight ng coins mo and wala sa kanilang fake. So, number 2. So, we have the left pan of the beam goes down, indicating that the fake coin is in the left pan. So, nandun sa kabilang isang side. So, ngayon, tatanggalin mo yung dip down kasi mas mabigat. Ititimbang mo ulit. So, it's either on the right naman na other situation. So, yeah. First weighing, if tips to the left, kung nag-tip ito dito, proceed tayo dito sa solution na to. If dito nag-tip, pupunta tayo dito. So, similarly, pag nag-tip naman dito, ito ay nandito either dito sa tatlo yung fake. So ngayon, pwede natin silang timbangin na isa-isa tatlong beses. Malalaman natin yung fake. Yan, so third weighing, yan na. So, if 4 and 5 are balanced, then coin 6 is the fake coin. So, the same with 1 and 2. Pag 1 and 2 nag-balance, 3 is the fake one. Kapag ka nag-dip ang 1, 1 yung fake. Pag 2 yung nag-dip, fake yung 2. So, the same situation with other weights dito. Okay. So, ganun yung problem solving ng example 2. So, example 3. Given a magic 6-pointed star, place the numbers 1 to 12 in the circle. Using one of each line of 4 numbers should have the same total. There are 6 lines in the magic pointed star. Adding each line, each of the numbers is considered twice. So adding number 1 to 12, we have 1 plus 2, 12 is equal to 78. 2 times 70 is equals to 156. Divide the sum of the totals of 156 by the lines obtaining the value of 26. Okay, so ayan. Meaning, dapat ang value na makukuha mo kada lines dito is 26. Pag ito, pinag-plus mo to, ito rin, and ito rin. So, dapat sila ay 26. Yan. So, alphametic. An alphametic is a type of number puzzle containing sum or other arithmetic operation in which digits 0 to 9 are replaced by letters of the alphabet. One of the most famous alphametic puzzles is one produced by Henry Dudney in 1924. He was an English author and mathematician who specialized in logic puzzles and mathematical games. So, example number 4, we find which digit is equivalent by each letters so that the addition is correct. Okay, send more money. So, the number send more and money, S and M cannot be 0. So, the sum of 2 4-digit numbers cannot exceed 19,998, thus M is 1. So, 1. So, M is 1. S plus 1 is equal to 0. Recall that S plus 1 is equal to 10 plus 0. Note that S is not equal to 1 and 0, O is not equal to 1. Hence, M is equal to 1. So, there may or may not be carry in 2,000 place. So, thus, O is equal to 0. So, palitan natin ng O ng 0. So, no carry into the thousands column. So, S is equals to 9. E plus 0 is equals to N. So, yan. E plus 0 is equals to N. Makita nyo to. Ito. So, N is equals to E plus 1. So, note that E is not equal to 9 and N is equals to not equal to 0. So, ngayon, yung S is magiging 9. Then, N plus R is equals to E. Ito. N plus R is equals to E. So, N is equals to E plus 1. Thus, 1 plus N plus R is equals to 9. Equals to 9 plus N or R is equals to 8. Okay. So, yung R naging 8 na. So, nasolve natin ang 8. And now, we have D plus E greater or equal to 12. Since S is equals to 9, R is equals to 8, and D is not equal to 1. So, by elimination, when D is equals to 7, E is equals to 5, and N is equals to 6, then Y is equals to 2. So, send more money is 9567108510652. So, that is the end of our chapter 3. So, hope you like it. And sana, madalian kayo doon. So, medyo nakakalito nga din kasi patterns and general ma yung ating inaaral dito. So, any question with regards to chapter 2, part 2, and chapter 3? Anyone? Hello? Yan pa ba kayo?
Wait, kasi yan lang siguro po ng file ng part ng chapter 3.
Ah, oh, sige. I-sesend ko na yung ano, chapter 3.
Thank you po.
Then i-upload ko lang ulit ito sa ano. Then sesend ko sa inyo yung link. And any question? Or kailangan nyo muna i-digest ang ating naging lesson?
Nagda-digest pa lang po, sir.
Oh, mukhang busog na busog. Wala makasagot. Wala akong ano ng tanong. Okay. So, week 4, create material, upload. Check ko lang ha, baka baliktad na naman to. Okay. Chapter 3. Okay, so na-post ko na yung chapter 3. Pakitingnan na lang. Then, after this, i-upload ko yung lesson today. Okay, so pahinga muna tayo sa assignment kasi katatapos nila ng quiz. And focus muna kayo sa inyong calculus. At meron ako mga nababalitaan na nahihirapan sa inyo sa calculus. Okay? So last call for any questions and clarifications. O mga naging tanong nyo na sa quiz dun sa yun lang, sa quiz, sa naging activity.
Marami daw po nagkamali dun sa rabbit.
Ah, marami nagkamali sa rabbit.
Wala po dun, sir. About po dun sa rabbit. Total po kasi yung pinaglalagay po namin. Hindi po namin alam na adult pala po yung hinihingi nyo.
Yun. So, yan ang iingatan nyo sa ano ha? Sa differential. Sa calculus, ingatan nyo yan. Pagka may word problem, basahin yung maigi ang word problem. Tsaka sa ano? Ang dinedevelop ko kasi sa inyo dito, yung sa word problem. Sa board exam kasi may mga ganyan. Word problem ang solution ay 1 point lang. So, kailangan nyo basahin ng ayos. Para yung sagot nyo, tama din. Diba? O, pag nagkamali kayo sa isa, dire-diretso yun. Tama, diba? Lahat yun, nagkakamali.
Apo,
sir. Yes.
Apo, sir.
Ah, sige, di, pero ano, di iwasan ko na lang yung mga ganun. Next time, basahin nyo ng maigi. Iwasan ko yung ganun na nakarelay sa isang ano, na madami yung tatamaan na ano. Okay, so, kung ano po ba, hindi, PPM kita mamaya kung ano yung regarding kanina dun sa ano, sa sinagutan mo. Okay. So, meron pa ba sa inyo? Last na ulit? At tatapusin ko na ang klase. Then, Then regarding sa midterm exams nyo, hindi ko sure kung online or face-to-face. Ibang gusto nyo, online, face-to-face? Face-to-face, no?
Opo, sir. Face-to-face po.
Oh, face-to-face tayo.
Opo, sir.
Sige, hahanap ko kayo ng room sa ano. Pag na face-to-face tayo. And, syempre, mag-quiz muna ako ng isa pa. Next week na lang ako mag-quiz. Oh, next week na lang sa 27 na ulit. Or sa 4. Okay. So, di na naman kasi tayo nag-face-to-face. Na-face-to-face nyo lang ay si Sir Len nyo, ano?